Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess. And in today's video, we're making this on the new logo design. The logo has been formed from the basic hexagon, which has got 6 sides. Then it has been subdivided into small pieces of triangle. So to design this logo, we'll first create that hexagon, then we'll divide it into small pieces of triangle using the very few small tricks. Then we'll delete out that unnecessary pieces. Then we'll add up the color and the font. So let's begin with the tutorial. So to start with the tutorial, we'll select the rectangle tool and create a square. Left click your mouse button, keep the width and height around 200 and click OK. So you create a square. Now keep the square in outline mode. Now select that, select the object path and split into grid, and we'll split this square into 5 rows. So we'll keep the rows around 5 and preview it and click OK. So you created that 5 rows. Now group this up, Control G, place it to a side. Now create a hexagon. You'll use the polygon tool, and with the shift and alt press, just drag it out and create a hexagon. Fill it up with certain different color. Now make sure to align the top edge and the top edge of the square like this, and in the same way with the shift press, just drag out and make sure the other piece also align. After that, we'll select the square and with the alt press, just drag it out this edge in such a way that it extends. Now after that, we'll bring this up to the front, arrange it to front. Duplicate this, Control C, Control F to paste in the front, rotate it to an angle and make sure the this edge align with the hexagon sides like this. Duplicate it one more, Control C, Control F, and in the same way just rotate it to an angle and make sure it's aligned like this. After that, we'll select this square and just drag it down or just push it up like this, in such a way that this edge is at this point. So just select and just bring it there like this. After that, the next thing is select everything, and with the shape builder tool, we'll separate out all the triangles. So select the shape builder tool and we'll open that color palette like this, color guide, and select the color, select the piece, select the color, select the piece. So in that way, you select the color and every piece you select will be filled up with different colors. So this is very useful. If you just like select everything, it will be of same color. So I'm just using variation, giving some variation to the colors like this. Select the color, select the piece, and your piece will be automatically separated from the rest of the design. So shape builder tool helps a lot. So just select it, select this, select the color, select this, select the color. So every piece is of different color and you can directly select that and fill it up with certain color later. So this is just working out like this. Select the color, select the piece, select the color, select the piece, and the piece will be filled up with the color which you are selecting like this. After that, next, once you have filled all the color, you can just delete out the rest. So we'll select everything like this, delete it out. Before that, just ungroup it, select this, and same way select these, delete it out, select these, delete it out, select these, delete it out. Now we are left only this. Next thing is we'll select these pieces, delete, select these pieces, delete, and next select these, delete. So we are left with these pieces. Now, as we see, after doing all that stuff, we got that design only thing. Select this, delete that out. Now, the next thing is to fill up the color. So, select this pieces with the eye picker, select the color. V for selecting selection tool, select it. Eye picker. Third color is this, or maybe this. Select this, eye picker, select this, eye picker, select this, eye picker, select this, eye picker. So it has made our work much more easier. Select this, eye picker. In the same way, we'll do the opposite stuff. Select this, eye picker, select this, eye picker, select this, eye picker, select this, eye picker, select this, eye picker. So in a way, you have done everything. Select and just fill it up with the color. And finally, our design is almost ready. You can see that by filling up the color, everything is good. But here are a few small pieces which are left out while we were doing the shape builder tool. So select all the individual pieces with the selection tool, with the shift press, and just move it aside a little bit so that we can delete out all the rest which are behind. So select it, place it here, group it for a while, and select everything which is here. So deselect this and delete it all. So we are left only this. As you can see, the design is ready. The only thing which we are left here is the text. So let's type out the text. So with a T for selection tool, type out MOTIO in motion. We are applying the font which is Shonar Bangla. Just I'm clicking this with the art picker. I'm just selecting the color and selecting the font, or you can just go in here and just type out Shonar Bangla and it will be there. Or if you're not having it, just download it and use it. Now after that, we'll just scale this down or bring it here around here. We'll just scale this up a little bit so that it matches the size of our logo. Just this much. We'll select this, scale it down a little bit, go to character, and with a shift press, just with this scroll your mouse and the number will gradually increase, and just increase it and make sure the font is around with I think 23, and keep the increase the distance between the each font over here. Just increase it and leave it, and place it there properly. We'll just decrease the font a little bit, or maybe just reduce the distance between each of the alphabet like this. And finally, we have finished our logo design. We have edited that hexagon into small triangles, and it was very simple trick. Then we added the color in a very simple way using the eye picker tools, because we have already prepared that color palette early before designing our logo, so it makes our work much more easier than we added the font. So this is how we can create these kinds of logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button, and if you like this video, please click the like button. Thank you.